Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon. This is Rick Phillips for CampusNation.com, the sports animal. I guess we're getting started here, Charlie. We've got about 29 and a half minutes before this women's basketball game is going to get underway. We have the Baldwin-Wallace Yellow Jackets, 11-1, coming in to play the Wilmington Fighting Quakers, and we are, of course, live over CampusNation.com, and on the WilmingtonQuakers.com website, we have an audio link. We are doing delayed HD video, which will be available on our website tomorrow evening, so you can tune in tomorrow evening on the Campus Nation website. This is one of two games we have today. This one, a women's college basketball game. Then as soon as we get down here, Charlie and I are packing up and heading to Greenfield McLean. Leesburg Fairfield will be in for the McLean Fairfield game tonight. That is a boys basketball game, and we'll have that as well following this game. Oh, I don't know, probably sometime around 7:15 on the Campus Nation Network.
Travis will be with us for that tonight.
Yeah, and guess who might be with us as well?
I didn't tell Travis that.
Well, it's going to be one fun, frolicky evening.
Well, if he comes, I may just let you guys handle it then, since I got the band tonight.
Do you have the band?
Yeah, but I can come back and forth.
All right, well, you can come back and forth. We'll let you. So anyway, Charlie Hargrave, as you have heard his voice, will be doing our play-by-play this afternoon. And yours truly will handle the camera and also take care of adding some color, as I always do. Charlie, speaking of color, you're eating those color...
jelly flops, belly flops.
Belly flops. That's the knockoff jelly bellies,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I tell you, they're good. Dollar tree, baby. A dollar for a bag of them. Plus, I got you your Werther's.
Right, right. That's right. And don't forget, today's game, as always, being brought to you by the Southern Barbecue, Memphis style of Bogart's, 975 South South Street, right here in Wilmington, Ohio. Looks like they got a banner falling down there, Charlie.
Yep, it does look like some kind of printing banner.
Yeah. But anyway, so we're going to get underway here, as I said, in about 27 and a half minutes. Charlie's got all the background information on both the teams. Charlie, you want to start us off
well,
here?
Well, I tell you, this should be, it's got the potential to be a pretty good game today. Wilmington's coming into the game 7-5, 3-2 in the OAC, and Baldwin-Wallace is 11-1 and 4-1 in the OAC, with their only loss coming to Mount Union, which was their last game. Baldwin-Wallace leads the overall series 28-13 and has won 8 of the last 9 meetings. Wilmington's lone win during the span came at Baldwin-Wallace last season, though, so Wilmington beat Baldwin-Wallace at Baldwin-Wallace. Preseason poll, Wilmington was picked to finish third in the OAC preseason poll, behind OAC regular season champion Ohio Northern and Baldwin-Wallace. Wilmington College senior Brittany Jefferson needs just 6 points to reach 1,000 points in her career.
That's great.
Yeah, Jefferson, a 3-year starter, has earned all OAC honors in each of the last 2 seasons. Sophomore McKenzie Campbell leads the team and is 5th in the conference, 15.3 a game. Campbell has scored at least 10 points in all but one game this season. She is 2nd in the league and is the top guard, making 50.7% of her shots. And she's only a sophomore, guys. On the strength of back-to-back dominating efforts on the boards, Wilmington is 5th in the league in rebounding margin at plus 2.9. The Fighting Quakers are 6th in the league in offensive rebounds with 13.1. And Wilmington is one of the 6 teams between 13.8 offensive rebounds. Proud Mary, senior Mary Moyer leads the OAC in rebounding with 9.2 boards, including a career-high 18 rebounds earlier this season. She has 3 double-doubles this season and 10 in her career. Jacole Tabor has been coming off the bench doing a great job. She was actually our guest here a few games ago.
I was downstairs during the pregame pictures that I take for Facebook, and she said, hey.
Yep, she's a good player. Tabor has played all 5 positions this season. Pleading the 5th, Wilmington College is ranked 5th in both scoring offense and scoring defense. A little bit about the Yellow Jackets. They're coming off their first loss, like I said, to Mount Union, and that was this past Wednesday, 72-62. Senior Sydney Clark and McKenzie Colombo combined for 35 of the 62 points to lead the Yellow Jackets. Colombo, the team's leading scorer, finished 16, has reached at least 10 points in six of the last eight games. Clark added a team-high 19 points, and she usually only averages about 10 per game. On the season, Colombo scoring a team-high 12.2, Clark adding the 10. Not only are they the top two scorers, they are the top two assist leaders for the team, combining for 68 assists. Sophomore Hannah Fecht is coming off the bench for 10.2 game and is second on the team with 6.7 downs. The guard is third in the LAC, making 46.2% of her three-point attempts. Senior Claire Levin, and also a starter, is the team's primary post threat with 7.6 a game and team high 7.3 rebounds a game. But they also have a 6'3 freshman.
She's a freshman.
6'3. No, wait a minute. No, I'm sorry. Junior.
Junior.
She's a forward. 6'3 forward. Megan Schubert. Coming off the bench, and it's interesting, local products from Baldwin Wallace. We have Casey Hughes from Springboro. She is a freshman. Anybody else local here? That's really about it. Most of them are up near the northern Ohio area.
Well, Schubert definitely has some height. I was down there on the floor taking some pictures as I hit her a little earlier, and she was big.
She's big. Yeah, well, 6'3".
Uh-huh.
She towered over me.
Yeah.
The Wilmington College women's basketball team allowed 18 points in the first 20, and they fell to Capital Wednesday 57-43. And we had a great game here with the boys against Capital, where the Wilmington College men
we
won.
Did, yeah.
If you get a chance, go back on the website and check that out. It was a really good game. There's like 20-some lead changes in it. It was really good. Wilmington shot just 7% for the Lady Quakers against Capital in the first quarter and 19% in the first half, falling behind 22-11. As the team, the Fighting Quakers, finished at 31% from the field, but just 15% from three-point land. Mackenzie Campbell finished with 18 points and 5 bounds. Senior Jefferson added. Brittany Jefferson had 7 points. Senior Mary Moyer pulled out a team-high 7 rebounds. So we got about 22 minutes. Both teams are on the floor. Wilmington's in their home whites. Baldwin Wallace is in their brown unis with a
pretty uniform.
Yeah, they got yellow tops on.
Those are their warm-ups right now.
Yeah, the yellow warm-ups. Wilmington's got their white warm-ups on. But this Baldwin Wallace team stands to be a stiff competition for Wilmington. But Wilmington, you know, their home record isn't bad. I mean, they're just a record overall, 7-5 and 3-2 in the conference.
They can beat anybody on any given day.
Oh, I think so. And their losses have come to Carnegie Mellon, who is a very tough opponent, at Ohio Northern, Thomas More, Illinois Wesley, and Titans.
Well, and Thomas More had won how many straight games?
Yeah, Thomas More only has won like 72 straight games.
Yeah, I think they're still undefeated.
And Wilmington only got beat in that game by like 2 points.
Yeah, so, I mean, Wilmington, when it's time to step up, they do it.
I saw our favorite cameraman out the Dollar Tree today.
He had his wasn't at the Dollar Tree.
He had his family with him.
Oh, Roger and his family?
Yeah.
I thought they were going to a car show down with Dave down there in Cincinnati.
They did yesterday.
Oh, did they?
Cavalcade of Customs is this weekend in Cincinnati.
Well, Dave didn't go yesterday. He did.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Dave wanders around. He doesn't have much to do, so he's always looking for something that he can get into free.
Speaking of car shows, February 9th.
You don't want to
excuse me, February 11th and 12th.
Let's get your car show date right there, Charlie. So you're old.
I know. February 11th and 12th out to Robert Center. Come on out.
Watch you some
kids. Just set it down there. There you go. I might get some later.
Yeah.
Chaz's Valentine's Day car show. It's open to all cars, and it's only $5 for the spectators to get in.
Chaz is. That's like the nickname you use. Are you connected with this?
Yeah, I run it.
Oh, okay.
You know what that Chaz is stands for, don't you?
Take it or leave it.
Yeah, Charlie Hargrave, as is. Take it or leave it. That's right. So come out and enjoy. The cars February 11th and 12th. Candy Blaze will be back out there. You might even get to see me play a little drums that night.
Candy, very active on Facebook, and of course she does all kinds of great restoration with old cars.
Right.
She's up there in Ashland, Ohio.
She's been pumping my car show real good. I've just been using a lot of her posts and just reposting.
Quite a creative young woman.
How'd you like our shirt design this year? Did you check it out?
It's nice.
The Duster and the DJ on there?
Yeah. Why didn't you use the cheerleader?
because it's not a cheerleader thing. Now, I did catch heck though for not using a pinup, so next year I might have to use a pinup.
Oh, yeah. Well, pinups. See, that's the point. It's about cars, but pinup would be very good for a local.
Well, we have a pinup contest that night, which you can be a judge at if you can make it.
Well, it depends on whether I've got prior commitments in some kind of sporting event. You know me.
You all come out and that should be your commitment that night. Come out and do the pinup contest on Campus Nation. I guess we have to be out on Talk TV, wouldn't we?
Right. It would be on Talk TV, our other network.
Keep calm and Chaz on pinup contest. There we go. Let me, you got to figure that out. That'd be fun.
Well, I've already got a cameraman there. I could always let you guys simulcast it.
Yep. There we go. That'd be fun.
Speaking, we were talking earlier about that great Wilmington Hurricane win last night. This is high school basketball for those of you that are listening in maybe from the Wilmington Quaker website. But our high school basketball team, which we also will broadcast when they're home our way, last night beat another local product, Hillsboro, 95-50. And it was a display of three-point shooting prowess on the part of the Hurricane. They shot 14 threes.
Wow.
On route to that 95 score. It was really phenomenal shooting, and really happy to see them. We had five players in double figures, really balanced, really nice nice game on the part of the Hurricane. We congratulate them, and there were several young men that had standout games, but probably Alex Wright, one of my Facebook friends, had a great game, scored 23 points. Go, Alex.
And he, you know what? That would be great if he could come to life, because that would just be somebody else for other teams to worry about. You know, he hadn't been somebody other teams would really worry about.
Well, Hillsboro came out in a zone, and Wilmington shot the lights out with threes. So, I mean, that zone went away real quick. They went to man-to-man after realizing the zone was not helping them.
How many threes? 17?
14. 14 threes. There were a total of 17, 17 or 18.
In the game.
There were. Hillsboro actually started shooting some threes there in the fourth quarter, at the very end. And they have a couple young men that are really good for Hillsboro as well.
Wow. Now, what else? Give them the schedule for the rest of the week here.
Well, of course, tonight we're going to be at your school, Greenfield McLean, for that Leesburg-Fairfield game that they're going to be challenging Greenfield tonight. And then as far as the schedule for this next week, I'll pull it up on our Campus Nation website. You can always go to campusnation.com if you're not coming from Campus Nation, you're from the outside area. But anyway, we have the Washington Blue Lions are going to come in this the 10th, which would be what, Tuesday night?
Tuesday night, yeah.
And we'll be on the air with our pregame at 7, as always. But the Blue Lions in to face the Hurricane. Wilmington has played a fair number of their games, their first games right here at home. Then we're back here on Wednesday night for men's college basketball. Muskingum Muskies are in to face the Wilmington Fighting Quakers. Once again, a 7 o'clock start time with our pregame. And then on Friday, the boys are going to travel to Chillicothe, and they're going to play the Chillicothe Cavaliers. Probably,
never been to that gym. How is it? Is it pretty nice?
From a broadcast standpoint, at least where we were last year, we were up, you know, they have upper areas like they do at Beaver Creek, but where we broadcast from it, they have a railing there that was kind of hard to be able to see over. I might ask for a table rather than, because we were sitting actually in the, you know, in the seats up there. And I talked with a buddy of ours that does the books for Hillsboro last night, and I asked him if they were still having problems getting any kind of signal out of Hillsboro High School.
Because,
and they said that Verizon is probably about the only carrier that can get a signal there inside the gym. Everything else, you got to be sort of outside the gym. So we're going to have to figure out what we're going to do. We'll either do a audio and tape delay when we go to Hillsboro, or we'll have to see if we can get someone with a Verizon phone that, or a hotspot, so we can make sure that we can get out, because Obviously, we're on two networks, AT&T and Sprint, and neither one of them, for whatever reasons, can't penetrate the walls of the school. That's a new school that they built there just south of Hillsboro.
Interesting.
Yeah. And then I guess after Wilmington plays to La Coffee, this Saturday we've got what will have to be a simulcast, and we'll have to get that all arranged because we're going to be in East Clinton all day long from about 10 till 6 o'clock for the East Clinton Duels. And that will be six teams competing against each other in dual matches as far as wrestling. And also, we will be doing women's college basketball. John Carroll, the Blue Streaks, will be in here to challenge the Wilmington Fighting Quaker Ladies, and that's next Saturday. So we will have to cover that game, which is a 2:30 pregame start, and we will also have another broadcast going on at the same time that starts at 10 o'clock out there, actually 9:30, in East Clinton.
So have fun with that.
We'll get all figured out.
I won't be at the wrestling.
Well,
the good thing
with wrestling is Bill Raybeck and probably Jim Marsh, their athletic director and junior high principal, will probably do our broadcast there. So if I can go out there, get everything set up, they can start their broadcast, then we can come back here, right. We can do this game, and then when I leave here, I can go back to East Clinton. That's the way we'll work it. The only thing we'll need at East Clinton will be someone to handle the camera, because and I don't think that'll be hard either, because we can see if maybe we can pry Roger away from his family for a Saturday.
I'd just tell Rayback to get a student.
And that's possible. We could do that too. Or I might even be able to get one of our Wilmington high school students to go out there and do the... because I'll be here, so I might as well do the camera here. And I think next weekend, actually this next week, the new Boxcast is in, so we'll be able to stream the Boxcast starting, I think, with this this coming Wednesday's game. As soon as Amir gets the IP address and all that straight with the IT department here at Wilmington College, the new Boxcast unit is in, in order to get through the firewall, you've got to have it already set up, and we kind of forgot that. So
we didn't forget that.
Well, no, but we'll Boxcast starting more likely Wednesday. But for those of you that want to see video of this game, our video for this game will be available tomorrow evening on the Campus Nation website. The Wilmington game from last night is up and on our website, so you can take a look at that. Maybe between these games, between the game here and when we go to Greenfield McLean. And then, of course, McLean's game will also be on the website sometime later Sunday evening. So CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports, with about 12 minutes to go before we start this women's college basketball game right here from Wilmington College.
Projected starters today for both Wallace Yellow Jackets. Number two, Casey Hughes. Again, these are just projected starters according to the program. Casey Hughes is a freshman guard from Springboro. She's averaging 3.4 points a game, a couple rebounds, a couple assists per game. Katie Smith, number 10.
She's a good singer.
You're thinking about Katy Perry.
Oh, no, I'm thinking Katy Smith singer. An older lady.
Katy Smith. Go. Actually, Katy Smith, if you remember, was a real good basketball player for Ohio State.
Yeah.
Anyhow, Katy Smith, she averages 4.9 points a game. She's a junior guard from Fairview. She averages a couple of rebounds, two and assists. Sydney Clark, she averages 10.4 a game, and she is a senior from Parma, Lake Ridge Academy. Mackenzie Colombo averages 12.2 a game. Plus, Sydney Clark, going back to her, she gets 4.8 rebounds a game, two assists. Mackenzie Colombo, 12.2 points a game, rebounds, two assists. And she's number 21. She is a senior guard, 5'7 guard from Strasburg. Clara Lemon, number 23. She is a senior forward from Canton, Louisville High School in Canton. For the Quakers, we're going to start with Ashley Andracki. She's number 20. She is a senior guard from Bishop Watterson. Brittany Jefferson, who averages 10.5 a game, and if you heard earlier in the pregames, will probably be on the regular 1,000th points today here at Wilmington College. She's from Chaminade Julianne. She's a senior point guard. Mackenzie Campbell, actually Brittany Jefferson's a wing, but she runs the point a lot. Mackenzie Campbell, 24, she is a sophomore from Cincinnati Turpin, really good looking ball player, 15.3 points a game, 5 bounds. Emily Harmon, she gets 6 points a game, she's a junior from Versailles. Mary Moyer is a senior, and she's from Martinsville. Clinton Massey, Ohio, 5'11". She averages 7.4 points per game, but almost 10 rebounds a game. So she's a force to be dealt with underneath, and she's not afraid to shoot the three either.
And her dad's here.
Yep, and it won't be nice to her dad. He's the prosecuting attorney here in Clinton County. So both teams, like I say, all on the court. We've got about 9 minutes till game time. Bill Lehrman's at his post ready to go. Coaches today, Sherry Horror is the head coach for the Baldwin Wallace. She's assisted by Cody Hartzell and Cassie Seth. Head coach for Wilmington College is Jerry Sheevy, assisted by Alan King, Jr. Whitney Barknett, Keith Anderson, Jr. also. What time did the playoff games start today, Rick?
I think they're like on at 4, like 4 and 8 o'clock, something like that. The Giants play today, I think. Well, I'd like to see them get beat. I don't want the Cowboys to have to face them anytime in the future. Obviously, since the only two losses that the Cowboys suffered this year are both by Giants.
That is true.
Got about 8 minutes to the game. Just a few of the Quakers still on the floor taking a little bit of...
Can't tell who's down there on crutches. Looks like we got two or three girls. They may not even be active this season because I can't really recognize any of them that might be out for this game. One thing about Wilmington College girls, they are very deep. They will play... Well, I'm just going to look through them here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, actually about 11 or 12 girls get some action.
At the same
usually,
time?
Usually about every game. Yeah. About every game they get the action. So,
speaking of action, who do you have on Monday night? Number 1 Alabama against number 2 Clemson.
You know what? After way Clemson played against the highest.
Yes,
state.
I know what you're going to say because I concur.
I have to go with Clemson.
I would too. Clemson definitely, to me...
They look like world beaters,
yeah,
didn't they?
They sure did. I cannot believe that Alabama will beat Clemson. So, and that's good because they'll get their retribution after last year losing to Alabama. So,
that quarterback for Clemson, he's the real deal.
Yes, he is.
Is he a senior? Is he going into the draft?
Yes.
Is he?
Mm-hmm.
I'd say he'd be a good pickup for somebody.
Cleveland.
Well,
they're going to have the number one pick.
I don't know if he's number one pick worthy or not, but he's good. I'll say that.
Well, I mean, if you're Cleveland, you're looking for a quarterback. So who's the best quarterback that's going to be in the draft?
I'm not sure this year. I mean, you think that guy would be the top or one of the top ones.
Yeah, now, you know, if a Tony Romo or something like that would leave the Cowboys and be out on the market.
Which is a possibility.
Yeah. Tony Romo has held about every record you can hold as a Cowboy. He's never impressed me other than the fact that he's got great stats because he's sort of an Andy Dalton type of quarterback. You know, can't get to the playoffs or can't win a playoff game or, you know, when the pressure is on. And obviously, you know, that's, you know, whether you're talking about any of the famous or currently famous football quarterbacks, it's the ones that win the big games that you're going to remember. It's not going to be the ones that just have the great stats. Actually, it looks like we're getting to fill up here. We're getting a nice little crowd here for a women's basketball.
I'll tell you what, it is freaking cold, too.
Yeah, I think the temperature out right now outside in Wilmington is 11. So it is a little nippy. I would not wouldn't do any ice fishing or skinny dipping or anything like that right now. You probably shouldn't put your tongue on a metal flagpole or anything like that. Just under 5 minutes now before our game tips off. Baldwin Wallace, they're in their all brown unis, trimmed in gold numerals. Smart looking outfits. I like the colors. That's also Kettering Altar's colors. I always like the gold and the brown color.
Really? Yep. Oh, to me it's kind of bland, but it's all right. Reminds me of Western Brown, the Broncos.
We don't have our normal stat bringer today.
Hey, where's she at?
She's out. She's from Springfield, she told me, but she's usually here all the time, even during the holidays and everything.
Yep.
So, hope she's not sick. Or
maybe a mayor's just giving her a weekend off.
Well, that would be nice. She's a hard worker.
She is.
And we see her at virtually every basketball game, even throughout the holidays. You know, when we're here, she's here. And same thing with football season, up there in the press box. She's like Amir's right-hand person.
Yeah, well, Wilmington College, they've hired a new football coach, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
An offensive coordinator, wasn't it, from somewhere? I can't think where he was from.
Well, I know Bill Rabeck coached with him, so and we're gonna see if we can start up a coach's show on Thursday nights is when I'm sort of planning that. It'll be a Campus Nation
Bill
sports
Rabeck
show.
Maybe going to help him out? Is he going to assist him at Wilmington?
No. Bill is he's a cross-country coach or track coach of some type over at East Clinton. I think he's planning on
football's in his blood.
Staying there. Well, it is, but I don't think, you know.
I don't think there's any possibility of that.
No, I don't think so. And this is going to be a rebuilding, you know, situation.
It always is with Bill, college football.
Well, it's the same thing with East Clinton. I think Bill Rabeck, after being at East Clinton, he's probably ready to just watch football.
Be on talk shows.
That's right.
Talk politics.
Well, I think that, and I think we will have on Talk TV tomorrow, the Razor's Edge or Sports Planet, one of those two from Generations Pizza here in Wilmington, Ohio, 7 o'clock. So for those of you that are not aware, it's talktv.us. That is another network that we operate that, all kinds of things. Your car show, Charlie, and Bill's political show, and a sports show that covers professional sports as well as local sports. Campus Nation, strictly D3 college sports and high school sports. And our Thursday night, we're going to try to see if we can hook it up so we can do that over at a local restaurant here, Damon's, and do it on Thursday nights. Like maybe before we head out to a game or something. Speaking of sports shows, we've got a sports show that we're going to be doing. It'll be on Talk TV and also WALH. Starts Wednesday.
This Wednesday?
Yeah.
What time?
This Wednesday. I can't tell you that.
Oh, come on.
You may want to come out and get a free meal.
Well, heck yeah, I do. Mm-hmm. I thought you wanted me as one of your guests.
Well, it's Rabeck's show. I don't get involved when it comes to ESPN type sports because he's so much more knowledgeable on that kind of stuff. And anyway, that'll be I think from 5 to 7 this Wednesday evening.
Okay.
And in fact,
well, we have a game though.
We do. That's why I was going to try to get them to change it so that maybe it was like 4:30 to 6:30, so that would give me a little bit of time because...
It's not going to give you any time.
We got men's
start
basketball.
Out here at 6:30.
I can always set up here one set of equipment, and then I can take the other set of equipment, and then all I have to do is break that equipment down, and we're already set to go.
Okay, we're getting ready here for the Star Spangled Banner. Got the Star Spangled Banner up over there? Last time they started playing something else.
I think it was Stairway to Heaven, something like that.
No, it was Beyonce, I think.
They are committed to the ideals of good sportsmanship. The great remarks directed at fans, officials, or student athletes are strictly prohibited and will not be tolerated.
Bill Lerman giving the behave, everybody behave speech.
Oh, he's talking to you, Charlie.
I'm way up here in the box. I can't hear me if I complain anyhow.
But we never complain. Quick straw. Hey, quick straw. Between a conservative college and a liberal college.
What's that?
Did you see the teams?
Oh, over
I
there,
know. Everyone.
Casey Hughes is starting for Baldwin Wallace. Brittany Jefferson. Countering for the Quakers.
For the Baldwin Wallace, running number 10, Katie Smith.
Katie Smith for Baldwin Wallace.
But no, she's not the singer.
Ashley Andrecki for Wilmington.
For the Baldwin Wallace, number 4, Sydney Clark.
Sydney Clark, number 4.
From Cincinnati, number 24,
McKenzie Campbell.
For Baldwin Wallace, number 21, McKenzie Colombo.
McKenzie Colombo for Baldwin Wallace.
From the 22, Emily Harmon.
Emily Harmon. Clara Lemon. Mary Moyer also starting for Wilmington. Says who we told you earlier, so
it all matched up.
Which it doesn't always. Last game it didn't, so. Wilmington will be in their white unis. They'll be going right to left to start out the game, and Baldwin Wallace will be in their brown unis going left to right on the radio dial. And we still have crowd rolling in here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just after 3 o'clock here. Girls college basketball, women's college basketball, we play
quarters.
4 10-minute quarters, no 1-1 anymore. Get to 5 fouls, you shoot 2 the rest of the quarter. Which, this is only second year for that. Clara Lemon going to jump for Baldwin Wallace and Mackenzie Campbell for Wilmington.
Still rolling in. Here we go.
Tips up, and Brittany Jefferson hits the ball from Campbell. And Drackey has it out on top. Baldwin Wallace looks like setting up a man-to-man.
Got right to left.
Wilmington is moving the ball around the outside. Try to get a little backdoor cut there. Mackenzie Campbell wasn't open. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Andraki has it way out by the W. And about a foul.
Pushed.
That's going to be on Andraki. Pushed off. So Wilmington quickly picks up their first foul. And we have a sub already. Anna Hooper coming in for the Quakers.
Did she replace Ashley?
Yes.
Okay.
Baldwin Wallace with the basketball. They're moving the ball around. Left side. Wilmington playing man. Three-pointer put up.
Whoa!
That's good.
Rolled around.
That's by number four. Sydney Clark puts the three in.
Since this is the northern hemisphere, does it rotate around that basket when it falls in a certain way?
I don't know.
Quakers miss.
Too deep there. Yep. Baldwin Wallace gets the rebound, brings it back down. 3-0, their advantage. Out to Clark on the right side. Gets it over to Smith. She delivers off to number 21, Colombo, and she puts in about a 10-footer with her left elbow. Brittany Jefferson has it. She gets fouled by number 2, Casey Hughes.
Well, maybe this is an indication that they're going to be real quick to call the fouls on this game.
Hooper inbound. Gets it to Jefferson out the top. Fresh 30 seconds. Moyer over to Campbell. Campbell dribbles up to the foul line. Gets it over to Brittany Jefferson. Dishes back out to Campbell. Campbell drives right side of the lane. Gets it stripped away. Gets it back. Shoots it up. No good. And the ball goes out of bounds off Baldwin Wallace, who Wilmington will retain possession underneath its own basket.
Lucky break for the Quakers. Stepped on the line.
5-0 right now. Yellow Jackets on top. Like I said, they're tough. They're 11-1 this year. They get the ball into Moyer. Almost knocked away there. Campbell has it, left wing, dribbles the lane, gets it out to Brittany Jefferson. She thought about the three, then backed off. Moyer, Campbell, Jefferson brings the ball back out, clear out on top near the W.
Don't forget,
gets it to Harmon. 9 seconds. Three-pointer put up by Jefferson, no good. Moyer tried to come down with the ball, but just tips it to the Baldwin Wallace player. Colombo thought about the three-pointer. Dishes off.
Three.
Three-pointer put up there. She kind of knew she missed out immediately.
Right.
She followed quickly, did Clara Lemon. But Brittany Jefferson comes down with the rebound. Hooper has it out on top. Jefferson drives the left side of the lane, puts in the layup. 5-2, so Wilmington finally gets on the board here, about 7:15 mark. They get the ball into Lemon. Lemon's working on Moyer.
Three.
Pass outside, three-pointer put up, no good. Rebounded by Jefferson. Three-pointer was put up by Katie Smith. Moyer has it. Over to Hooper. Hooper thought about the three and backed off. Try to get it in to Emily Harmon. She puts the shot up and gets fouled.
So she'll shoot two.
She gets fouled by Clara Lemon. Her first, team second. And Emily Harmon will go to the line to shoot two. First one's up. That's good. Mm-hmm. Second one's up, and it's good as well.
Oh, 5-4.
So Harmon comes out, and Tabor comes in. Like we said in the pregame, one of the Wilmington strengths is they have a lot of depth.
Yeah, they can continue to bring in those fresh legs.
6:30 to go here, first quarter. Baldwin Wallace with the ball. Up a point. Working the ball around the outside. Wilmington playing man as well this game. Going to the lane, let her go right down the middle. Casey Hughes, and she gets the bucket. 7-4, Baldwin Wallace. Brittany Jefferson brings the ball back down for Wilmington. Dribbles way down to the left side. It's out to Campbell. Campbell out to Hooper. She's working the ball around the outside. Jefferson has it. She dribbles the foul line, pulls it back out. Goes all the way down the middle of the lane. Puts up a kind of a crazy shot. No good, but resets the shot clock. Tabor with a rebound. So Jefferson now on top. 20 seconds on the shot. Gets it to Tabor near the right elbow. She throws it over to Hooper. Hooper inside to Mary Moyer. Campbell, right side, fights her way up and gets the bucket. 7-6. Oh, nice backdoor cut.
Foul.
Yeah, foul.
Call that a Wilmington.
Fouls on Kenzie Campbell, her first, team second. As Campbell comes out of the game.
Each team with two fouls.
And into the game comes Morgan putting on the Ritz. Ball rolls inbounds. Tabor steals it, knocks it into Hooper's hands, and Wilmington going the other way. Andracki back into the game. She has the ball out on top. Gives it to Hooper. Hooper, a three-pointer, and it's good.
Grandpa liked that one.
9-7. That was a long-distance three.
It was.
Shot put up in the lane by Rachel Woldman off, and it was no good. Going back to their way. Wilmington has it. Ritz has it. Over to Hooper. And Draghi on the outside. Dishes out to Hooper. Hooper pumps another three.
Got it!
Good.
Is this another three fest? Timeout. Baldwin Wallace looking pretty good. Savannah Hooper on those threes. Wilmington has the lead, 12-7. And of course, Savannah, a Wilmington product.
Yep.
7-6. Her sister Sawyer and her, both they're twins, and played for Wilmington. And there is some basketball background there.
Yep. 7-6 was the score here just about a minute ago, and Wilmington has put up two threes now to make it 12-7. Baldwin Wallace got the 30-second timeout, so it'll be their basketball.
Just wanted to cool the Quakers off a bit.
Down under the Wilmington College basket.
Get them out of their rhythm. 4:32 remaining in this first quarter of play.
No press or anything like that shown by either team yet. Baldwin Wallace with the ball. Columbo has it. Gets it over to Schill. Back to Columbo. She puts the shot up. They're going to call the foul on Tabor.
Two shots.
So going to the line is Mackenzie Columbo to shoot two. First one's up and good. Second one's up, and this goes as well. 12-9. Andracki bringing the ball up for Wilmington. Gets it over to Ritz. Back out to Moyer, way out on top. Andracki has it. Into Hooper's hands, who shot the last two. 10 on the shot clock. Andracki has it.
Tabor.
Gets it. Back to Tabor. Shoots the ball up. No foul. Looked like she got pushed on from behind.
I thought that.
Oh, Colombo got away with a travel there. Rebounded by Moyer after the shot, and we're going the other way. Pass way down court to Ritz. They're moving the ball around. Now Hooper has it out on the right side. Dribbles toward the foul line. Gives it off to Moyer. And Moyer throws it away right into the Yellow Jackets' hands. Long three-pointer by number 15, Hannah Feck.
That's good.
12-12. 3 minutes here to go, first quarter. Nice backdoor cut by Andracki. She puts the ball up, and it gets blocked out of bounds, so it's going to stay Wilmington's basketball. 17 seconds on the shot clock. Full line change here almost for the Quakers. The only one that stays in is Andracki. Smith, Harmon, Campbell back into the game.
Foul.
Campbell draws a foul on number 12. Riley Schill, that's going to be her first.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to let her get away with much today. You know, they're calling those fouls pretty quick.
I thought they were going to call that offensive for a second. She kind of lowered her shoulder into her. Ball comes into Campbell, fresh 30. Oh, she gets tripped up, loses the ball.
She's still
down on the floor, slow to get up. Down the other way, number 5 puts it in for the Yellow Jackets.
They're going to call timeout. Official timeout for an injured player.
I think she's bleeding, maybe.
Yeah. She's got a problem with the elbow.
The fans kind of letting the referees have it here a little bit.
About the no call?
Yep. Campbell did end up on the floor. There's been a couple times down where it looked like it could have had a foul called on Lauren Wallace for pushing the Wilmington College player, but no call was made. So 14-12, 2:46. We're just waiting for the injured player to be able to come back on the floor.
A reminder, tonight we've got boys high school basketball from Greenfield McLean. The Leesburg Lions will be in to play Greenfield the Tigers. So it's the Lions against the Tigers tonight on campusnation.com.
Oh, my.
About 7:15. You didn't know they were Lions?
No, I knew that.
Oh, okay.
Haven't you ever heard the poem?
The poem?
They want lions and tigers and mine, yeah. Wow, Rick, you've led a sheltered life.
I have. Yes, I'm very sheltered.
You've led a sheltered life.
Yeah.
Again, they're cleaning off the floor right now because there's blood on the floor and there's Mackenzie Campbell still bleeding. They're still doctoring her up on the sideline. So, been back and forth here the first quarter.
I think the biggest lead right now has been 5, and that's been by the Quakers. I think they were like leading 12-7, something like that.
Yes,
right,
they were.
Right now, Wallace leading 14-12, so the Yellow Jackets have made a little run here.
Roll Wallace, 11-1. Referee's trying to get this game playing again here.
Time is money, Charlie. Time is money. Today's game being brought to you by Bogard Southern Barbecue, 975 South South Street in Wilmington, Ohio. They're open 11 to 5:30 Tuesday through Saturday. Closed on Sunday and Monday.
Oh, we found more blood on the floor that we need to get cleaned up.
She must have been bleeding profusely.
Yeah. Well, Rick, I'm just about done watching the Nikita thing that you told me to watch. I've got like three more episodes. Don't tell me anything about it.
I'm not going to tell you anything about it, but you like it, huh?
Yeah, yeah. I've watched them all but three. There's like 72 episodes.
Yeah, there's...
Did you watch them all?
Yeah, I try to watch the series that have several years, because I hate this when you watch like a one-year series and then you're waiting, you know, it's like,
Well, that's what I just started watching one the other night called The OA. Boy, that thing is strange on Netflix. It's okay, but it's just strange. The OA.
What's that stand for?
If you like fantasy stuff, that's all I can tell you. I mean...
Quakers have the ball.
Yep. Andracki, three-pointer from the corner. No good. Jefferson gets the rebound. Pulls it back out. Gets it over to Tabor on the right wing. Jefferson dribbles left side. Throws back to Andracki. Trying to get Harmon open there in the middle. 13 on the shot clock. Jefferson out front. She pumps up the three-pointer. Oh, and misses everything.
As they say, air ball.
Yeah, that wasn't good. 2 minutes, 12 seconds to go here, but Wilmington just down two. This Bolden Wallace team, again, remind everybody, going into the game, they were 11-1, and Wilmington 7-5.
Are they ranked at all? Do we know?
I don't know. It doesn't say that in here. Wouldn't surprise me if they are.
Well, 11-1, I would figure you'd have to be ranked somehow. Top 25.
Columbo has it. Dishes off for Bolden Wallace. Bentler has it. Gives it back to Columbo. 7 seconds on the shot.
Running out of time, girls.
Crazy shot put up with the shot clock going out, and it's no good.
I never heard the shot clock. Did it go off?
No, because they got it off in time.
Oh, okay.
But it was like 2 seconds when they hit the rim. And Wilmington gets the rebound, and they brought it back down. Andracki with the ball gets it over to Harmon. Andracki, she fires up a three. It's no good. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Wilmington.
So the Quakers will be bringing it in under their basket.
Jefferson drives the left side, puts it up, and that's good.
Nice little drive, tied it up.
So two more points, and that should be her 1,000th point.
Do you think they'll stop the game?
I don't know. Be nice if they did, but probably not.
Tied up.
Travel on number 13, Kara Marshall. Hooper comes back into the game.
I'm sure Bill will probably say something, even if they don't stop play.
If he knows. 14-14, but Mary probably will tell him.
Bill knows everything.
104 to go. First quarter. This first quarter's kind of went on for a while.
It has. Seems like two quarters. Or a half.
Campbell has it. Gives it off to Jefferson. She dribbles the left side. Loses control of it. Gets over to Moyer. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Back out to Jefferson.
Clock, girls. Clock.
Tabor has it underneath. Shoots from the right side. And it's good. Good. 16-14. Wilmington back with the lead. Smith has it. Gets it over to Columbo. Back to Hughes. Just working the ball way outside. They're not even close to the three-point arc.
Yeah, but 8 seconds.
Columbo has it. Being guarded by Jefferson. Hughes shot up. Three-pointer.
Oh, that's good. And that was from downtown.
So. So at the end of the first quarter, Walden Wallace 17, Wilmington 16. Scoring so far, we have Casey Hughes with 5 with that long three-pointer at the buzzer. Sydney Clark with 3, Tiffany Bentler with 2, Mackenzie Columbo with 4, and Hannah Fecht with 3. For Wilmington, Brittany Jefferson has 4, Savannah Hooper has 6, Mackenzie Campbell 2, Emily Harmon 2, and Jacole Tabor 2. So, decent first quarter of action here, Rick. Really can't complain.
No, back and forth. As always, the ladies always very entertaining and always usually in the game, at least here at home. I can't speak for away.
No.
Although I think they were down, let's see, what's the last game we did for the men?
They were Capital.
Yeah, they were down to Capital by a bunch, and then they came back. Now, I don't...
Well, they ended up still getting beat.
Yeah, but still, they came back.
They got beat by 14 still.
Baldwin Wallace will have the ball out on side out. They've got the arrow pointing their direction.
Baldwin Wallace up one, just scored to three, and gets the ball right back because of the possession clock. Possession arrow, I guess I should say.
Foul.
I should call a travel on that because they're going to call a foul.
Well, you usually will travel when you're tripped.
Fouls on Campbell. That's not good. That's her second. So she comes out immediately. And in comes Morgan Ritz. Ball rolls. Having a little trouble getting the ball in bounds. They do finally. Lemon had it. Gets it over to Hughes. Shot, three-pointer from the left wing.
Got it.
And that's Sydney Clark. That's how the game started. She shoots a three. Baldwin Wallace goes up four. Wilmington with the basketball. Hooper has it on the right side. Shoots it from the right elbow. It's off. Baldwin Wallace with a rebound. And they're going down quick. Colombo has it. Pass over to Hughes. She drives the middle of the lane.
Got it.
Puts the shot up. Almost unguarded, really. Puts it up, and that's good.
I think this is BW's largest lead as well.
Yep, 22-16. Brittany Jefferson drives the lane.
Block.
Ball gets knocked out of bounds by Baldwin Wallace. Going to stay with Wilmington. 17 on the shot clock. Jefferson inbound. Gets it to Ritz. Ritz shoots two-pointer up. No good. And just inside the key. Going the other way. Balls and travel. Travel on McKenzie Colombo. So it's going to go back to Wilmington. So that's what I thought they should have called last time as a travel. And that time they do. Very similar play. Jefferson bringing the ball down. It's over to Moyer. Moyer had the open three. He passed up on it. It's underneath. Jacole Tabor underneath. She puts up the little bunny. It's no good. And the Baldwin Wallace rebounder, Casey Hughes, grabs it but falls on the floor out of bounds. So turns it back over to Wilmington with a fresh 30. Jefferson inbounded to Ritz. Out to Hooper on top, back to Jefferson. Jefferson saw about the three. Instead, drives the middle of the lane, puts up the shot, and that's no good. Ritz steals it. She's going to go to the left side, puts the shot up, and they're going to call the block.
That was good anticipation on Ritz's part.
On number 23, Clara Lemon, that's going to be her second. First shot's up. It's good for Ritz. .22-17. Chance to make it .22-18. That's good.
Two for two.
So Wilmington down four here. They need a couple more stops to get back even here with the Yellow Jackets. Clark has it. Gets it over to Hughes. Hughes to Smith. Wolmendorf has it. Clark shoots a shot up.
Got it.
Got the left elbow, and it's good.
She had Jacole was draped all over, and she still made it.
Yep, pretty nice looking shot there. She's one of their leading scorers there. Ritz drives the middle of the lane, puts up the little runner, and it's good. Ritz, just a freshman from Seymour, Indiana. Hughes has it for Baldwin Wallace. Long cross-court pass over to Colombo. She puts the shot up. It's no good. Rebound the dough by Baldwin Wallace.
Uh-huh.
Brittany Jefferson gets called for the foul.
That was nice. She came and helped Brittany back up.
I like that look. Brittany didn't think she fouled her. She just about mugged her, though.
Who, me?
Did you see that face?
I did that?
Ah. 24 to 20. Baldwin Wallace back with the basketball. Trying to add to their lead.
Nice.
Now a little fadeaway there by Sydney Clark, this time from the right side, right block.
They're really good there inside the paint.
Yep, 26 to 20. Jefferson has it. Gets it off the table. Mary Moyer thought about the three. Jefferson has it on top. Pass under the table.
Good pass.
Puts the shot up, and it's good. 6:20 to go here. 26-22. Baldwin Wallace on top. And with the basketball. Colombo has it way on top, being guarded by Jefferson. She gets it over to Clark, who scored the last several buckets.
Nice one.
Clark is the left baseline, puts it up.
Switches to her right hand.
30-second timeout by Wilmington College. Yeah, Clark, yeah, somebody better. They got, that's probably what the timeout's for. You got to control her. She's their best scorer. She just, it's like she just now come to life.
Yeah.
One of their best scorers, we'll put it that way.
Just over 6 minutes remaining in the first half of play. Baldwin Wallace out ahead of the Quakers, 28-22.
Yep, 6 minutes. Wilmington bringing the ball back up, 28-22. Baldwin Wallace matches their biggest lead of the game so far. Looks like Baldwin Wallace showing a little 2-3 here.
Looks like it.
Long three-pointer by Jefferson. No good. Fighting for the rebound. Now there comes Clark. She gets it underneath with a big tall girl, number 14, Megan Schubert. Well, her first points of the game. She's a 6'3 player, junior. Moyer from the foul line. No good. Misses everything. Tabor gets the rebound, puts it back up. That's good.
So Charlie, looks like Oakland plays Houston today at 4:35 and Detroit plays Seattle tonight at 8:15. So Giants play tomorrow.
Play, let's see, who is that?
Green Bay.
The foul is on Harmon, it looks like. Ball rolls with the basketball. Trying to extend their lead to 8.
3.
Three-pointer put up, misses everything. And Wilmington comes out with it. Brittany Jefferson. Campbell's down the floor scrambling for it. Excuse me, as Ritz down the floor scrambling for it. Ritz, long three-pointer.
But she's fouled.
No, they called a travel on her.
So she traveled before she shot.
Yeah. That was a long three-pointer. That was clear out the volleyball line.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't being guarded. Thought she could hit it. 4:40 to go. Baldwin Wallace with the basketball.
Another three.
Yep, three-pointer put up long distance. No good by Clark. Jefferson brings the ball down. Oh, Jefferson throws it right into Clark's hands going the other way. Wow, they're going to call a foul there. Okay, I guess they're going to call it on Reds, I assume.
She did like a little hop and then jump and was fouled in the process.
Fouls on Reds, her first. And that's the fourth Wilmington College foul already this period. First shot's up and good by Sydney Clark. Yeah, she did like a little hop step there, didn't she?
Uh-huh, yeah.
She's a good ball player. She is a senior. Next one's up. That's good as well. So, Baldwin Wallace opened up to an 8-point lead here. Wilmington needs to get a little more serious, get some scoring going. Now Baldwin Wallace back to man-to-man. Hooper thought about the three. I'll pass it off to Harmon. She wasn't ready for it. And she loses control of it and goes back to BW. Shot at the foul line.
No arc on that whatsoever.
13. Kara Marshall throws the line drive shot in there, but it was good.
So,
Wilmington down 10 now.
Gotta regroup here.
That quick. You know, that was pretty quick.
It was quick. Today's game brought to you by Bogard's Memphis Style Southern Barbecue at 975 South South Street right here in Wilmington, Ohio. Give them a call. You can carry out. You can actually eat in the dining room. You can go through the drive-thru to pick up. That's Bogard's Southern Barbecue, and their phone number is 937-655-8100. Give them a call.
Andracki bringing the ball down. See if she can get Wilmington started here. She picks up a dribble.
Yeah, I was going to say, Moyer. Like she traveled.
She tries to throw it to Tabor, but led her too far, and the ball goes out of bounds. So, another turnovers. Turnovers are playing their toll here on Wilmington College this quarter.
Yeah, you can't take an 11-1 team and have those kind of turnovers. They're going to blow you out of your gym if you're not careful.
Ball and Wallace with the basketball. Just working ball around and got into the big girl. She travels, though. Number 14, Megan Schubert. Megan Schubert's got some height, but she don't have any bulk.
No, she's very thin. Probably weighs all of 90 pounds.
Probably weighs a little more than that just because she's taller.
But that's you're not gonna say anything about a woman's weight, Charlie.
You're giving them the right idea.
That's
though.
Right.
Hooper has it. Gets out to Moyer. Andracki. Back to Moyer.
Working the ball.
Excuse me, Harmon. Andracki shoots the shot up. No good.
Still going to be a shot.
Nope. Must have caught a part of the rim.
Yeah, so they reset it.
Andracki has it out on top. To it to Harmon.
Good pass.
Back out to Andracki. She fires up a three. Didn't really seem too ready for that. Going to call a foul or jump ball?
And it's going to Wilmington.
Well, one referee has a foul. The other referee has a jump ball.
And the call goes to the foul.
I think that's going to go on Moyer. And he is hearing it from the crowd right now. And, there's one of those cases again. You know, you got the guy that's 2 feet away from the cabal making the call, and the guy 10 feet away overrules him. I have a hard time with that sometimes. Shot up is good for Megan Schubert, the first one, because they're shooting two now, because that was Wilmington's fifth foul. She's also a lefty, Rick.
Well, I can appreciate that, being a lefty myself.
Next one's up, and that's good. Ray Moyer. Long three-pointer puts it in.
That was needed.
Yep, 36-27. Baldwin Wallace with the ball quickly down on their end of the court, though. They don't mess around. They get the ball down quick. Clark Clark. She gives it off to Matthews. 7 seconds, shot clock.
Got a foul. Was that a player control foul?
Yeah, we have an off the ball foul on number three, Mackenzie Matthews.
Jefferson coming back in.
That's only two for them for the entire half, for the entire quarter.
Yeah.
And Drakey bringing the ball up. See if he can cut into this 9-point Baldwin-Wallace advantage. And Drakey works around the right side. Picked up a dribble. Can't get any help. Gets it out to Tabor. Tabor over to Brittany Jefferson. Mary Moyer from the corner. No good. It's rebounded by number three, Mackenzie Matthews. We're going the other way quickly. Moyer knocks the ball out of bounds there.
Good hustle.
On the long pass. So, ball and roll is getting their inbound right there in front of the Quaker bench. Kara Marshall inbounds to Stacy Hughes. Back over to Marshall. They get the ball into the girl, big girl. She puts it up. No good by Megan Schubert. Wilmington College back the other way. Harmon shoots up the shot. No good.
Foul? Is that a foul?
I think they're going to call a foul, yes.
It's going to be against BW.
Yep. Again, on Mackenzie Matthews. Wilmington College inbounds to Mary Moyer. Back out on top to Brittany Jefferson. Still just needs 2 points for a 1,000th point. Jefferson has it way out on top by the W. 1 minute left to go in this quarter. In the lane, Mary Moyer puts up the shot. Kind of out of control, no good, but the rebound comes down to Jefferson. She dribbles into the lane. Wow. Harmon puts up a crazy shot. No good. Tabor gets the rebound, and she gets fouled as she's going up.
She's going to have two shots.
Megan Schubert with a foul. So Tabor going to the line to shoot two. First one's up, and it's good. Next one's up. That's good as well. Rattles around, but comes home. Tabor's got eight so far today for the Quakers. She's Wilmington's leading scorer thus far.
That was off the bench.
Yep. Travel. That's Tiffany Bentler travels for Baldwin Wallace.
Zigged when she should have zagged.
So, yeah, well, Baldwin Wallace kind of returned the favor to Wilmington. Wilmington gave them a bunch of turnovers earlier. Ritz coming back in for Hooper. So 36-29. Yes, be nice to cut this down to 3 points. 3 or 4 point lead again. Get away from that 10-point advantage. It was for Baldwin Wallace. And Drackey has it out on top. And there's not much difference between it and the shot clock, so Wilmington's probably going to be going for one shot here.
About a second and a
half. 9 seconds. And Drackey, 6 seconds. 5. She goes down the right side. Dishes to Ritz.
Lock.
And Ritz gets blocked.
1.2 seconds.
So 1.2 seconds to go. Baldwin Wallace basketball. They got to go the length of the court now. Then we're going to have a wild shot put up here.
A little short.
Looks like Jefferson might have fouled that girl on the last shot.
7-point lead here.
Did you see that?
No, didn't see it.
You don't think so?
No.
So what you did see, you just don't want to admit to it. Are you related to Sergeant Schultz?
I see nothing. I hear nothing.
We'll give you some official stats here in a few minutes, because right. We'll get official stats. So we'll
but what is official is at the half, the Quakers are down by 7.
That's the main stat.
Right.
So 36-29. And Rick, I'm going to take the mic off for a few minutes, but tell them about what we're doing the rest of the day.
Yeah, it looks like Amir's going to have to go up and get his copies of his stats himself. So they're not in the top 25. Okay. Anyway, coming up tonight, we've got boys high school basketball. The McLean Tigers against the Fairfield Lions, and that is from Greenfield McLean. We'll be on the air at about 7:15 with our pregame. Game's going to tip off at about 7:45, and this next Monday, we have, once again, boys high school basketball, or Tuesday. The Washington Blue Lions are in to face the Wilmington Hurricane. And that'll be a 7 o'clock pregame with about a 7:30 tip-off. A lot of that depends on the junior varsity game. The freshman games, they sort of tend to go over a few minutes here and there. So sometimes we don't really actually get started till about 7:15, 7:20. But for sure, we'll be back here on Wednesday. Men's college basketball, Muskegon, the Muskies against the Wilmington Fighting Quaker Men. And that game will start right on time at 7 o'clock. We're going to have our first Sports Planet broadcast from, what's the name of the Mexican restaurant, Charlie? You remember?
Not the new one.
Yeah, I don't know. The new Mexican restaurant here in Wilmington, Ohio. I'm going to have to get the name and write it down. Even Lee doesn't remember that. But anyway, I'm going to try to see if we can make that more like a 4:30 to 6:30 so that at least we can get things packed up quickly and get back over here to start our broadcast. We may start with the actual tip-off rather than a pregame. We'll just have to see how that works out. But that is this Wednesday. And then we have boys high school basketball, and we'll be traveling to Chillicothe, Ohio, the Cavaliers to face the Hurricane. The big thing on Saturday, we've got an all-day East Clinton Duels wrestling meet. It's a tourney. There'll be 6 teams involved. That includes East Clinton. That'll tip off at about 9:30 in the morning, and it's going to go till about 6 in the evening. As I said, 6 teams involved in that tournament. And we will also be doing at 2:30 women's college basketball. John Carroll, the Blue Streaks, in to face the Wilmington Fighting Quaker Ladies. So, a lot of action this coming week on CampusNation.com. And for those of you that are tuned in from the WilmingtonQuaker.com website, we do this all the time. So if you're listening, if you're listening from the Baldwin-Wallace listening area, we want to welcome you to our broadcast network. Take some time and look over our website, WilmingtonQuakers.com is where you're listening, but we're on CampusNation.com, and we've got all kinds of interesting high school sports, from wrestling to swimming to you name it. And of course, we have Wilmington Quaker football, and we probably have Baldwin Wallace football, some games in there somewhere. We also have ladies basketball and men's basketball from college on the Wilmington Quaker part of our website. Amir, our sports information director, making his way slowly up to our booth. Yeah. Why don't you go down and meet him halfway, Charlie? Two big men don't want to work too hard. All right, I'll go down since I'm such a thin, spry fellow.
Oh, I actually met the girl the other day. Oh, 10 minutes and 34 seconds here before we start the third quarter. It's been kind of back and forth. I mean, Wilmington's down 7, but not quite out of this game. They were down 6 earlier, then went ahead 4. So it's been back and forth, topsy-turvy. While Rick's away, I'd like to remind you that the Chazzo's Valentine's Day car show at the Roberts Center is coming up February 11th and 12th. If you guys have old cars, you'd like to register one, it's only $20. The charity is the Alzheimer's Association of Cincinnati. We've been able to give over $5,000 to them over the last 7 years. So I'd like for you guys to, if you're in the area, come out and support the cause. If nothing else, it's only a $5 ticket. Get you in both days if you don't have an old car. But there'll be vendors out there. There'll be lots and lots of cool cars. We've got a couple cars.
Pinups.
Pinup Girl Saturday night. We got 30-06 playing Saturday night. We got Elvis there Sunday. The King will be in the house. So you guys like to come out and check that out. Plus, maybe you'll see Rick. Who knows?
Yeah, that's a possibility. Well,
and Dave.
Dave. Riding the Wave with Dave, our buddy from WKRC in Cincinnati. And his show's on tonight. He's been off the last two Saturday nights because of the holidays, so he'll be...
He's always off.
That's true. Yeah, he'll be hitting the airwaves again tonight. And that's on 550 on your radio dial, on the AM dial in Cincinnati, Ohio. So the Yellow Jackets leading the Quakers 36-29. They shot 59.1%. They were 13-22 from the free throw or the three-point line. They were 40%, 4-10, and from the free throw line they were 100%, 6-6.
So is Wilmington.
Yeah. So both teams shooting 100%, 6 out of 6 for the Quakers as well. The Quakers only shot 31.3%. They were 10-32, and 33.3%, 3-9 from three-point shooting. So right now the edge in shooting overall is with the Yellow Jackets, and of course they've got the lead. There were two tied scores, and the lead changed four times. In the paint, Baldwin Wallace with 10, Wilmington with 12. Off turnovers, Baldwin Wallace with 12, Wilmington with 7. Second chance points, BW with 2, Wilmington with 8. Fast break points was all Baldwin Wallace. They had 9 points off fast break, Wilmington 0. And off the bench scoring, as we would expect, and it happens all the time, Baldwin Wallace with 11 points off the bench, Wilmington with 18. Charlie, you want to give us the actual individual point totals?
Sure, we can do that.
That's your area of expertise anyway.
Okay. Sydney Clark, 14. Mackenzie Colombo. She only has 4 so far, so they've held her kind of in check. Casey Hughes, 7. Tiffany Bentler, 2. Kara Marshall, 2. Megan Schubert, 4. Hannah Fecht, 3. And then for Wilmington, Emily Harmon, 2. Mary Moyer, 3. Brittany Jefferson, 4. Mackenzie Campbell, 2. Savannah Hooper, 6. Morgan Ritz, 4. And Jacole Tabor, 8. Rebounds, offensively, Baldwin Wallace only has 2 to Wilmington's 13. They're doing a better job there on the boards. Defensive rebounds, 10 for Baldwin Wallace, only 8 for Wilmington. So Wilmington is actually out-rebounding BW, 21-12.
That's hard to believe with BW's height.
Yes, yeah. The score has been tied twice, and the lead's only changed 4 times, but it seems like it's been more than that. But it has changed 4 times. It shows you the type of game we got going right now. First quarter, it was 17-16, Baldwin Wallace. And then the second quarter, Baldwin Wallace put a 6th spot, 19-13 over Wilmington. And that brings us to our score now, where Baldwin Wallace is up 36-29. Foul trouble. Mackenzie Campbell has 2 for the Quakers. Clara Lemon has 2 for Baldwin Wallace, but that's about it. No one else really has anything happening there. Andracki does have 3 assists. Turnovers, each team has 7. And that kind of surprises me because it seemed like Wilmington, there for a little stretch, that's all they were doing was turning the ball over.
Right. Well, then BW came back. They turned it over a few times.
Yeah, right after Wilmington did. It was kind of funny. It was like 2 little stretches there. So
BW is back out on the floor warming up. Quakers haven't come out yet.
They had a lot of time left. 5 minutes to go. Now, you don't really have to be in a rush to get over to Greenfield tonight. I got to be over there about 5:30 because I got kids coming for the band.
Yeah, Charlie's the band director at Greenfield McLean.
For one more year.
This is it.
Yep, 31 years. Ford Huntington, 12 at East Clinton, and 15 down at Greenfield. Hopefully more of my kids will show up tonight. Last night we had a game and we didn't do too bad. We had about 25 there, but no school yesterday. A lot of their parents didn't want to let them come out because they thought, no school, shouldn't be a game, but we had a game anyhow. So.
Doesn't usually work that way. I mean, it's so difficult in the wintertime, particularly when you're talking all the winter sports, which there are more winter sports than there are fall sports, as an example. And you've got so many of them that require, since it's cold outside, the gym. And so getting teams scheduled in the gym for wrestling or for basketball for girls or basketball for guys, you almost have to pull these games off no matter what, unless it's just absolutely a blizzard or something outside.
Put the ball stuck in the basket down here on this end. There they go.
Down there in front of Grandpa.
Have you heard anything from our cohort up north lately?
What cohort would that be? You don't remember their name. That's
AJ.
AJ, if you say up north, yeah, I guess he is up north in Troy. No, I've not heard anything from AJ. You know, he's in love. And actually proposed to his girlfriend, and now she is his fiance. This was just before Christmas. In fact, he recorded it and put it on Facebook. I don't know whether he Facebook lived the whole thing, but so
that could have been dangerous.
If it was live, it could have been. She could have said no.
Oh, give him the 50-50 number. I didn't get one today.
Well, Joe Davis bought one last night at Wilmington, and he said that if he won, he was going to buy you a Coke.
So I take it he didn't win.
No, he didn't. We couldn't get them to call his number.
Now, you're saying Jumpin' Joe is coming tonight, maybe?
He might be. He's supposed to let me know here at the end of the game here, because he would have to ride with me.
Just you and him last night, wasn't it?
That's right.
Travis had a game.
Yeah, Joe was—he seemed at first a little distracted last night. I don't know why. He just—you know how Joe is. I didn't think we were going to get the game off because he was busy talking to everybody but doing the game. Joe's such a social butterfly. You know how he is.
Oh, I know.
Well, I mean, you know, all of you are. I'm the only down-to-earth guy in the Campus Nation crew, folks. Everyone else say narcissistic.
Oh, my. Yeah. Oh, my.
See, Charlie's admitting it.
Pot calling the kettle black here, folks.
We're coming.
That's why Dave would be a perfect fit for you, see?
Dave. Now, we won't say anything about poor old Dave since he's not here to defend himself. Joe Davis is a little different.
Actually, yeah, I tell you, Joe's fun to work with. So's Travis, and I like the
Bill.
Bill, yeah, Raybeck.
Bill Raybeck.
We had a good time that night,
man. And I'll tell you what.
And Craycraft. Craycraft.
Jeff hasn't.
Craycraft is probably your most knowledgeable one.
Oh, no question about it. He's really, really knowledgeable and really, he paints a good picture.
Well, him and Travis.
Yeah.
Travis is pretty knowledgeable, too.
Yeah.
36-29. Didn't really start the third quarter. Wilmington will be going left to right. Bowen Wallace will be going right to left. Looks like Wilmington will start with the ball, so that's a good thing.
Well, that's always a good thing. If you're going to start, you might as well start with a ball. I mean, it is basketball, Charlie. I mean, you wouldn't start with a hockey puck, right?
Well, but you could also start on defense.
See, that's is that what you meant?
That's the part
you're
missing.
Well, you should have said that, Charlie.
Well, most knowledgeable sport fans would get that.
Oh, is that it?
You, on the other hand, plays with Barbie and Ken dolls. We have to explain everything. So anyhow, here we go. Wilmington with the ball. Campbell has it down low. Gets it out to Jefferson. Jefferson's still looking for that next basket to get her 1,000th point. Ball's knocked away. Campbell has it. Over to Andracki. Andracki puts the shot up. No good. It's rebounded by Lemon. And quickly down court for the Yellow Jackets. I mean, just immediately down court. Wilmington still playing man-to-man. Hughes has it. Gets it over to Smith. Ball's on the floor. Hughes picks it up. Colombo. Clark has it now. Clark's a good ball player.
Clock's
4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds.
Gotta take the shot.
Wrong shot is partially blocked, and Moyer gets the ball on the partially blocked shot. So we're going back the other way. Campbell has it. She's going to try to dribble the left side. A foul's going to be called on number 10, Katie Smith. That's going to be her first. Ball's inbound to Andracki. Andracki dribbles right side. It's knocked away. Back to her, though. Jefferson has it. Pass underneath. Tried to get it into Emily Smith, but just wasn't there. Or Emily Harmon, but just wasn't there. Ball and roll. It's the other way. Three-pointer, left side, wide open. Katie Smith, three-pointer. 10-point advantage, Bolden Wallace, 39-29. Pass into Moyer, didn't go up with the shot there, out to Brittany Jefferson. She gets knocked on her butt, but no foul called. Going the other way is BW. Shot from the left side, two-pointer put up, no good. BW gets the rebound there. Ball's loose underneath.
Jump. Foul.
Well, we got a foul call, but who are they going to call it on?
Good question. Mary Moyer?
No.
It's on BW.
Clara Lemon, that's her third.
She's going to have to take a seat.
So she goes out. Looks like Rachel Lemon-North back in. Ball Wallace with a 10-point advantage. Wilmington needs to get on a run here. Campbell has it. Gets it out to Jefferson. Andracki, right wing. Backdoor cut to Harmon. Pass underneath the Moyer. Couldn't get the shot up. Campbell underneath the Harmon. To Harmon, loses control of the ball. Gets it out to Andracki. 6 seconds on the shot clock.
Got to shoot.
Jefferson gets over to Moyer, left side. Shot put up, no good.
Got a foul. Going to be against Wilmington. Is that Jefferson's foul? Who was that on?
I couldn't catch that. Who was that foul on? Man, mark it up on the board.
Must not have been on Jefferson.
Go to the bucket by Bolden Wallace.
Making a three.
Shots missed. Bolden Wallace still has the ball underneath. To Womendorf. She puts the shot up. No good. And it's come out of Wilmington. Campbell underneath. Puts the little layup in on the right side. That's good.
Down to eight.
39-31.
Three-pointer,
left side, no good. I'd say Bob Wallace's coach can't be too happy with that. Didn't run the offense or anything. You're up eight. Andracki has it out on top. Gets it under to Moyer. Moyer backs away, shoots the shot up, no good. But Campbell's right there for the comeback.
6-point lead.
Campbell getting a little hot. That's what Wilmington needs. 39-33. Jefferson tips it away, and this could be the 1,000th point if she doesn't get blocked.
And oh, she does.
Blocked,
they going to call a foul?
No.
She got blocked. She got blocked by Sydney Clark.
Yeah, but are they giving it to BW?
Yeah, and the ball went out of bounds on Brittany Jefferson. So it's going to go back to Bowden Wallace. Yeah, that's probably in the back of her mind. She's probably like get that 1,000 points over.
Get it out of the way. Almost takes
stolen it again. Mackenzie Campbell on the breakaway. She gets up, puts the shot up. That's good.
Timeout, Baldwin Wallace. 4-point lead.
Last 6 points have been scored by Mackenzie Campbell.
Yep. Today's game brought to you by Bogarts.
She only had 2 in the first half. Now she's got 8.
They're open Tuesday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. You can call them at 937-655-8100. Oh, he's tying his shoe. I thought he was still looking for blood from earlier in the first half.
Never know. Hey, Ron, we don't need any more delays like that.
975 South South Street, right here in Wilmington, Ohio. Bogard's Memphis-style Southern barbecue with that sweet potato pie that Charlie likes.
That's good. We need to get some barbecue sometime.
Yeah. When you're treating, I'm ready.
Well, I'll listen to you.
Well, I mean, I've bought every time that Marty's brought it in.
So no Marion's this week, huh?
Marion's is Beaver Creek.
I know. You're not going to any Beaver Creek games this week?
No, later. Bellbrook at Beaver Creek.
Ball and Wallace moving the ball around. On the outside. Moment to man. Hughes has it.
Get a stop and cut the lead.
Long three-pointer. Put up and in by Sydney Clark.
Much needed by the Yellow Jackets.
She has 17 on the day, 42-35.
Nice game.
Campbell with the basketball. She scored the last 6. She's going to try and make it 8. She gets hammered. I don't know why it took so long to call that foul.
Yeah, well, she's going to shoot 2.
And effect is her first foul. And the Campbell's going to go to the line and shoot 2. Bolden Walls coach giving the referee a little way to go over there. First shot's up, no good.
Too strong.
Way too strong. Marshall. 42-35, Bolden Wallace on top by 7. Campbell, second one, up, and it's good. 42-36, Bolden Wallace down in it quickly. I tell you, they don't mess around. Oh, they lost the ball there, though. Number 15, Anna Feck, lost it. And Wilmington has it again. Chance to cut this lead a little bit. Pass in to Moyer. She goes up strong underneath the left side, but no good on the shot. The ball's knocked out of bounds, and it's going to go back to Baldwin Wallace.
Okay, what do we got here?
Who knows what they're talking about? Probably where they're getting dinner after the game.
Bogarts. They'd be open for another half an hour.
Ball and Wallace bringing the ball up. Number 12 dribbles the right side. They get the ball out to Clark. Clark is having a game. Over to Fecht. Back to Clark. Campbell almost got the steal there. Fecht has it. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Ball's almost thrown away. 1 second.
Okay,
shot clock violation, so it's going to go back to Wilmington. Warrior out, Emily Smith coming in. Emily Smith.
The youngest Moyer has arrived.
And Drackey. It's over to Campbell. Goes in on the right side lane and puts it up, and it's good. Wilmington's cut it to 4. It was up 10 by Baldwin Wallace. See if they can get a stop here. Keep closing that gap.
Well, BW's always come back with a 3 when Wilmington's cut the lead like this, so we'll see what happens.
Going to the line. Clark, wow, who's strong?
Back up.
Rebounded by number 22, though.
Clark, nice quarterback. Got poke in the eye there, I think. Finger in eye. I'm going to check her out.
She might be coming out.
Well, she's going to have to if she can't keep her eye open.
We're going to sub this time or we're going to wait? Last time we waited while we had an injured player. Looks like we're going to sub this time. Moyer going back into the game.
And also our 6'3 junior coming back in for BW.
You like her, don't you?
Well, I mean, 6'3.
I know. Megan Schubert. Moyer back in the game for Tabor. Wilmington moving the ball around the outside. Hooper thought about the 3, gets it into Moyer. Moyer puts a little spin move up and gets it in.
Once again, down to 4.
44-40.
Fans getting on the ref. 3.
Shot from the right side, no good. But ball rolls, rebounds. Clark has it on top, gives it over to Colombo. Colombo's been pretty quiet here in the second half. Clark again. Drives left side lane, gets it taken away, and Wilmington ends up with it. Moyer comes out of the group with it. She gets it over to Andracki. 44-40. Andracki. Back to Moyer. Oh, and they try to throw it in. It's just too hot. Yeah. And Emily Smith.
Right idea, just a little too hard.
I don't even know if the right idea. She was pretty covered. Jefferson back in the game. Baldwin Wallace with the basketball. Oh, wide open 3. No good. Rebounded by Jefferson. Shot was put up by Katie Smith. In and out. Moyer has it. Gets it to Campbell in the lane. She's shot up. No good. We got a foul.
Against Wilmington.
Against Moyer.
Push off. Now Wilmington out with 2 fouls. The Yellow Jackets with 3.
Baldwin Wallace with the basketball up 4. 1:50 to go here. It's third quarter. Hughes has it way out on top. Gets it over to Colombo. Colombo passes to the left side to Alex Starr. 7 seconds. Travel on Hughes.
Once again, the shot clock was running down, and I think a little bit.
Force it up.
Yeah.
Tell you what, Baldwin Wallace, coach, not happy. She's wanting all kinds of fouls and stuff called by the referees and not getting it. Campbell tried to make an extra pass. Or she just went up with the shot. Yeah. She tried to throw it underneath the Harmon.
Going
to
stay with the Quakers.
Ball just knocked out of bounds.
Jacole coming back
Tabor in. Tabor coming back in. Harmon going out. So she must be all right. That's good. Brittany Jefferson gets it in. Hooper, three-pointer.
Foul.
She gets fouled, and we're going to be shooting three. Number 32, Alex Starr. Wow, and cut it to a one-point game here, Rico. What do you think of that?
Yep. I can dig that.
First one's up. Oh, rumbles around and falls in.
That was like a three-second basket.
Yeah, that thing took forever to fall in. Hit the front of the rim, the back of the rim.
Second one good.
Second one right down the pipe. 44-42.
See if she
can hit the trifecta here. Yep. And she does.
Nice shooting.
44-43.
Wilmington's within one now, Charlie.
Yes. Bowen Wallace with the basketball. Allen top. One of the buckets, number 32. She gets fouled by Tabor. Minute three left to go here.
So she'll be shooting
quarter.
Too.
Going to the line is number 32, Alex Starr. No good on the first one. Just kind of threw it up there. Didn't look like she was even ready to me.
Uh-uh.
Second one.
Same way.
No good either. We'll have it over the back here on number 22, Rachel Womendorf.
And that is the fifth foul on Baldwin Wallace. So we're going to come down and shoot some free throws. So right now, BW with five fouls, Wilmington with three.
So a minute left,
Wilmington will be shooting the bonus.
Tabor, first one's up. That's good.
Looks like she's recovered from her poke in the eye.
New ball game, 44-44. Minute two to go, third quarter.
Cole can give us the lead here.
Oh, just off. 21, Kalenzi Colombo bringing the ball up. Gets it over to Hughes. Hughes has it on the outside. We're working the ball around the left side now. Hughes.
Oh.
They throw the ball out of bounds. Number 10 tried to save it.
Plenty of time.
Balls. Katie Smith from the pass from Hughes and goes out of bounds, and Wilmington's going to get the possession back here.
Most likely with the last shot with
40 seconds to go. Brittany Jefferson bringing the ball up. Hooper, I thought she was going to take it, didn't you?
Too, yeah.
28 seconds. Only 13 on the shot, though. Brittany Jefferson with the basketball. Pass underneath the Hooper. She gets fouled, but nothing's called. She puts the shot up, and it's no good. A lot of contact there. No foul called. 7 seconds.
BW doesn't act like they know what they're doing here.
Oh, Mary Moore, you're lucky not to get the foul called on her.
Oh, that was close.
Last minute shot put up by 22, Rachel Womendorf. No good. So here we go. We've played three quarters just to be back to where we were when we started this game. 44-44.
Well, when we started the game, it was
0-0, but it's a tie, right?
Yeah, you knew where I was going with that,
Rick,
didn't you?
Rick,
Charlie, you are just sharper than a tack today.
Rick, you have a knack for the obvious.
Yeah. That's why I'm so beloved.
I'm saving all these green jelly beans for you. Why don't you eat a couple of them? Yeah.
Is there a significance to that?
No.
You just don't like apple jelly beans? Or do you think I need them?
I think you need them.
Tonight, our second of the two games that we're doing today, boys high school basketball, the Lions of Fairfield against the Tigers of McLean.
And Bears of mine.
And the...
You finally got that now, didn't you?
Yeah, I got it.
It took you a while.
Yeah, oh, I'm going to leave that paper.
I'll be measuring my paper in.
Charlie's got all the little jelly belly, jelly flops lined up there in a row. All right, well, we've got 10 minutes remaining, unless we go into overtime. That couldn't be possible. And the arrow points in BW's direction,
yep.
So they will be taking the ball outside out.
Outside out?
Yep, outside out. It's cold outside. About 11.
Baby, yes it is. All right, here we go, 44s. BW with the basketball. Wilmington needs to keep up the good play from the third quarter.
Out of bounds.
BW loses the ball out of bounds.
She just bounced it off her foot. So, BW shooting themselves in the foot, so to speak. Ha ha ha.
That last quarter, BW scored 8, and Wilmington College scored 15.
Can this be 2? No.
Wilmington College with the ball. Mary Moore, I don't even know where she was throwing the ball area to. I mean, there wasn't anybody there, and she throws it right in the 3 BW
players.
There
was.
Players.
There were 3 BW players.
Yeah.
There. Shot. No
shot
good.
From the left elbow. No good by Clark. They've kind of held her in check for a while, which is good. She's a really good ball player. Ashley Andrecki. This ball.
Get it. Oh, I thought she was going to shoot a three.
Brittany Jefferson pass into Mary Moyer.
Good.
She puts the ball up underhanded. She likes shooting that underhand shot.
Oh, and Wilmington with the lead.
46-40. 8:45 to go. This would be a good game for the Quakers. Upset. This would be a definite upset.
Oh, yeah, it would be.
Oh, blocked by Moyer, and she gets the ball, and she's bringing it down the court. For Wilmington, gets it over to Brittany Jefferson. Jefferson being kind of harassed here by Casey Hughes out on top by Bolden Wallace. Mary Moyer from the right side misses everything. Mackenzie Campbell, though, gets the rebound.
Throws it away.
Almost throws it away, but Brittany Jefferson saves it. But only 4 seconds on the clock here.
Put it up.
She puts the shot up. No good, though. Too far underneath the basket. Just took the ball right up through the lane. Going the other way.
Three.
Shot's put up. Oh,
wow.
Travel. Travel.
So the basket doesn't count.
Nope. Travel on Casey Hughes.
So the Quakers still remain in the lead by 2, 46-44, with 8:01 remaining in the game.
Andrecki bringing the ball up. Wilmington needs to keep this run going. Throwing in a pile of players, though. Andrecki, three-pointer. It's short. Campbell, though, nice rebound.
Very nice.
He's playing nice and aggressive as a sophomore. Gets it to Tabor. Tabor goes up and makes
foul.
The shot and is fouled.
Good move by Jacole.
Jacole's got 11 today.
She needs to get poked in the eye more often, right?
Fouls on Cindy Clark. That's her first.
So let's see if she can finish up the three-point play. Got it.
Tabor.
Oh, Wilmington with another nice 5-point lead here.
Yep, Tabor at 12. 12 points. Wilmington's coming from a bunch down. 7 down now to go 5 up. 12-point turnaround.
Timeout.
Now we have another 30-second timeout by Alden Wallace. Their coach is ticked over there on the side.
Today's action being brought to you by Bogard's Memphis-style Southern Barbecue, 975 South South Street, right here in Wilmington, Ohio. And they're open every day other than Sunday and Monday from 11 a.m. to 5:30 p.m.
I think we're going to have a little cruising out there at the Broush Brewery this summer, and Marty's going to cater it.
Right, because Broush has no food. They're a local brew pub, and they don't have food. They simply supply the alcohol.
That could be a fun night.
It could be.
Wilmington up 49-44. Bolden Wallace with the basketball. 7.5 here to go. Clark has it on the left side. She gets it.
Nice drive.
Into Colombo. Moves in, puts the layup up off the left-hand side. 49-46. Wilmington up 3. Andrecki has it on top. She just drives down the middle lane,
blocked.
Gets it knocked out of bounds by Colombo. That was a good show. You remember that show?
Every time you mention her name, I'm thinking of a trench coat and a cigar.
Yep. And I always used to get it confused with Beretta. Beretta and the Parrot. Remember Beretta?
Yeah.
Oh, bad pass underneath. Colombo just takes it right away out midair. Sorry, Ben Wallace for the tie. Shot was up. No good. But Ben Wallace rebounds. Colombo has it out on top. Hits it over to Fett. Down into Clark. They're just moving the ball around. Back out to Colombo, left side.
Goes underneath.
Shot's put up, and she gets fouled. Shot was put up by Clara Lemon, and she gets fouled by Mary Moyer, her third.
Each team with one foul this quarter. BW wanting to cut into this three-point Quaker lead.
They can do it real easy right here. First shot's up, no good.
They've missed their last three shots now.
I'm telling you, shooting down on this end of the floor, there's just something with the depth perception.
You think it's the balcony there?
Might be. Second one's up, no good. Mary Moyer gets the rebound, so Wilmington still holds her three-point lead. Jefferson has it out on the right side. It's with the Moyer. Campbell now on the left side. Tries to throw it to Moyer, but the ball gets knocked away. Katie Smith has it for BW. She drives right down the middle of the lane, puts a shot up, no good. And Bolton Wallace still has the ball. It's Colombo has it out on the left side. She passes it to Fett. Pass underneath, number 10, Katie Smith. Ball gets taken away by Whitney Jefferson. We're heading back to Wilmington Way.
Oh.
Crazy passing.
That'll still be the Quaker ball underneath their basket. It was off from Mary Moyer, off one of the BW players.
Wilmington's lucky to have retained possession. They're just kind of playing out of control. Settle down, make good passes.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't want to get in a big turnover war here.
No, we'll leave that up to BW.
Mackenzie Campbell drives the right side lane. She gets blocked. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Riley Schill in the game for Bolden Wallace. Get the ball into Campbell. Campbell, turnaround jumper, left side, no good. Rebounded by Clara Lemon, going the other way. Schill has it. Get it out to Sydney Clark. Colombo.
Thought about it.
Get the ball to Fett. Fett dribbles the left side lane. Back out to Colombo.
9 seconds.
Over to Schill.
Gonna have to shoot.
6 seconds on the shot clock.
Gotta shoot.
Three-pointer put up by number 12. No good. Gets her own rebound, though.
Good follow.
So new 30-second clock. Fett on the three. No
still
good.
Still gets a rebound.
Fett gets her own rebound. Yeah, Wilmington's not hitting the boards here at all.
They're not boxing out.
Going to the going down the lane was number four. Clark, she misses it, and Tabor comes out there with it.
So Wilmington still with the three-point lead.
A little bit of drought and scoring here the last couple of minutes.
Oh, they were running some
pass
time off.
Pass to Jenny Jefferson.
Nice.
She gets it in.
And is that two?
I think that means that she scored 1,000 points. I think that's what I read earlier in the program. So 51 to 46. Bolton Wallace with the basketball. Three-pointer. No good. Rebounded by Campbell. Yep, she just needed 6 points. So Brittany Jefferson now has 1,000 points in her Wilmington College career.
Congratulations.
Nice pass underneath Brittany Jefferson. And she misses that bunny, though.
Got a jump or a foul?
I don't think they're calling a foul. Maybe on the BW player?
No.
On Tabor.
Is that her fourth?
That's her third.
All right. Second team foul. So Wilmington with two team fouls and BW with one. Here we go. Here we go. This is. This is the 1,000th point. So they are stopping the game and they're recognizing it. Congratulations, Brittany Jefferson. 1,000 points in Wilmington career. Basketball?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Brittany Jefferson will get that ball, probably put displayed here at the college somewhere for her 1,000th point here as a Wilmington College Quaker, senior guard out of Chaminade Julianne High School.
An Eagle. And now a Quaker.
And Jacole Tabor's cousin.
All right.
So, ball and roll is back with the ball, down five. And Jefferson almost gets the steal.
It's out on Wilmington. Now they're talking it over. Fans are all calling white ball. What do we got?
Well, one referee, I think, again, is calling it one way. The other is calling it another way. Yeah. Or maybe it could be the shot clock they're talking about. Maybe they need to reset it.
So they're going over to the table to talk while we all just
sit and wonder.
That's right. Okay. Well, it has something to do with the clock because obviously they're not... turning the possession over to Wilmington. I don't think.
Oh, they moved the shot clock instead of at 28. It's down to 16 now.
All right. So, BW still has the ball, but with 16 seconds left on the shot clock.
Must have forgot to start it or something. I'm not sure. So, 13 seconds. BW with the basketball. Almost stolen by Campbell.
We're going to have a violation here. There it is.
Shot clock violation. Bolton Wallace. That's at least the second time that's happened
like
today.
Like three times.
Yeah, at least the second.
Yeah, they haven't managed their shot clock very well.
51-46. Wilmington up five. 3:33. Upset in the making here, folks.
Of course, part of that is the good Wilmington defense that these Quaker girls have been putting on. So.
Yes, they have been. Moyer drops it off to Jefferson, over to Tabor on the right side. She hands it to Campbell. Campbell drives right side, no good with the real runner. Bolden Wallace comes out there with it. Twenty-one drives right side. She gets hammered by Brittany Jefferson. That's Colombo. So Colombo will go to the line to shoot two. First shot's up, and it's good. Second one's up. That's good also.
So their free throw drought is over.
51-48. Jefferson with the basketball. Wilmington with the lead. 3 points. Campbell has it. Almost gets it taken away by Colombo. Get it out to Moyer. Back to Campbell.
He's going to try.
Campbell gets it out to Tabor. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Jefferson almost loses it. Goes up left side, puts it up, and it's good. So that's her 1,002nd point.
Are we going to keep track of that, Charlie?
No, I just thought you'd like to know
okay.
that.
Okay, all right.
In case you didn't know that.
Stolen
away. Poor math there. All right. Oh, ball's knocked out of bounds, but it's going to stay with Wilmington.
All right.
53-48.
Fans still getting on the refs. Guess they thought that was a foul.
Yeah, it could have been. Definitely a reach. Hasn't necessarily been our best crew that we've seen this year. They seem kind of unorganized. Maybe they don't work together normally. Jefferson has it out on top. 2:12 to go. Wilmington back up five. Almost loses it and does lose it.
Good takeaway.
Feck takes it away. Colombo bringing it down. She's just going to go straight to the basket, unguarded, and puts it in.
Wow.
53-50.
Wilmington College defense fell apart there.
Campbell underneath the Jefferson. She gets it out to Hooper. Three-pointer. No good. Ball is saved, though. Back to Hooper. So Wilmington.
Thank you, DW.
Retains possession. It was a good save by Clark. She just
gave it to the wrong team.
Yep. Campbell.
You got a new shot clock. That helps.
Mary Moyer has it. Right wing. Looking for somebody to break through underneath. Not happening. Hooper has it. 7 seconds. Jefferson over to Tabor. Tabor.
Got to take the shot, girls.
Puts it up. No good. Ball's
scrum
on the floor.
It'll be Wilmington's ball.
Timeout.
So the jump ball would have been Wilmington's anyway, but Wilmington manages to get the timeout in. BW's coach, she's saying, what? What?
Yeah, she wasn't real happy with that. Wilmington up three with exactly 1 minute left to play here in this game.
You're listening to Lady Quaker Basketball here on CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports. And speaking of high school, tonight we will be in Greenfield for the Greenfield McLean Tigers against the Leesburg Fairfield Lions. The Lions against the Tigers.
The Bears are mine. Hey, we got an upset in the making here, Rick. 53-50. Wilmington, this would be a big win for Wilmington College.
It would be. But these Lady Quakers have played some pretty good basketball that we've seen here at Herman Court before. Wilmington taking it in under the basket. Brittany Jefferson. Here we go.
Jefferson inbound.
1 minute left in this ballgame.
Campbell. Full shot clock.
B-Dub is going to have to foul.
Jefferson has it way out on top. Well, they've only got one foul.
That's true. There's only one possession.
Fouling isn't going to help them. Jefferson goes down the middle of the lane. Gets the little layup.
37 seconds.
Going the other way. Colombo shoots the shot up. No good.
Trying to three.
They get it out to Clark. That's who you want it.
Got a foul. See, we don't want to do this. You don't want to stop the clock and give them the opportunity.
Well, foul's on Tabor. This is her fourth. I mean, Wilmington, they had one to give there, so there's no foul shots there. 28.2 seconds. Shot clock is off. Ball's inbound.
Three.
Wow, wide open.
Got it.
You can't. How do you do that? You can't leave her unguarded.
All right.
Sydney Clark.
20 seconds remaining in this ball game. Wilmington up by 2 points.
Feck trying to get the steal on Jefferson.
There
and she is foul. But that's on the floor.
Right. And it's only the second foul. Got a timeout, Baldwin Wallace.
Full timeout. So Wilmington will have the ball in. They're up 10.7 seconds to go.
Right.
And I'm going to split on you tonight because...
Yeah, that's right. You go ahead and head out. Packed up.
I got to pick the kid up, and we got to get over there for the other game because I got to be here earlier for the band.
Got to tune your tuba, right?
Yep. Whatever you say.
What instrument does your daughter play?
She plays the mellophone, which is a marching French horn, basically. She plays French horn in concert band, though.
All right, with 10.7 seconds, you're down two. Obviously, the other team has the ball. What do you tell your team?
Don't give them the ball. I mean, they're going to have to foul you. Don't shoot. Just play keep away.
So that's, if you're Wilmington, what you would be saying.
Yeah, you got to get the ball in your best ball handler's hands. You got three fouls yet for them to give in 10.7 seconds. That's not going to happen.
Yeah, that's right. You're not going to get 3 fouls.
Even if they foul you, you just got to make sure you get the ball in.
All right.
And they're going to be guarding you tight. You know, figure out some kind of pick play to to get somebody open just to receive the pass.
They're trying to put extra pressure on the inbound pass.
Campbell, gets it in, and she's they're going to foul, and they're going to do that like three or four times here. 9.6 seconds.
That's all they can do.
Fouls on number 10, Katie Smith.
Then there'll be some pressure points here. All right, back in again, trying to steal.
They get the ball into Jefferson. There's another foul. There's 8.5.
Now they're effectively doing it. They're each team with four fouls now.
Fouls on Sydney Clark.
This foul.
So the next one, say they've got to shoot.
All right, Wilmington will be in the 1-1.
No, they'll be in the 2-1.
Oh, that's two. Two foul shots.
Oh, that was a dangerous pass. Black again, been stolen right there.
Okay, so that's fifth foul.
Yeah, so Tabor will go to the line here, 7.5 seconds. She sinks both of these. We're in good shape.
Right.
She misses one. That opens the window of opportunity for Bolden Wallace.
Yes, we don't want to go into overtime tonight.
No. Shots up. That's good. First one's good.
Ice in her veins.
This is the real important one, though, right here.
Right. This would make it a two possession. Come on, Jacole.
Second one's up. That's good.
All right. Timeout. Bolden Wallace. They're going to talk it over, figure out how they can get 4 points out of 7.5 seconds. I don't think it will happen.
No,
main thing Wilmington doesn't want to do is foul. They don't want to send him to the line and stop the clock.
No.
So I wouldn't care if they, of course, now by calling the timeout, once again, the ball is preceded to the half court line. So that's another reason that they probably did that. They don't have to bring it the length of the court.
Right.
Oops. One of those rule changes when they change the rules to quarters for the ladies.
Yeah, I don't think I like it.
I don't like any of the changes. I think it was fine to play just like the men play.
It's 13-9.
And we're not going to
quarter.
Yeah, we're not going to do the stats wrap up. If you need stats, you can go to the WilmingtonQuakers.com website. We're basically going to end the game and start packing and heading out. I've not heard from Joe Davis, so
they may and Travis.
Right, you and Travis.
57-53, 7.5 seconds here, and Bolden Wallace gets to take the ball out in front of their own bench. I mean, the only thing they could hope for would be a three-point play, made shot with a foul. And they about lose the ball there. Oh, she walked. They let her get away with the travel.
That's it. Oh, whoa. No, Mary is going to go to the line with 1.7 seconds to go. This is sort of a done deal.
Her first foul, Colombo. Her and Mary Moyer looked like they were going to tangle it for
they
a minute.
They did, yeah.
So Moyer, 1.7 seconds. The Wilmington College Quakers are going to get away with a nice upset, nice victory today. The first one's up by Moyer. It's good.
Just a reminder, our video will be on our website tomorrow night if you want to relive this and actually see the video.
And Mary Moyer makes a second, 59-53.
That's it.
Wow.
Nice win for the Lady Quakers. So, Bolden Wallace, along with Ohio Northern, picked to win the OAC this year. Lady Quakers with that sort of upset.
And they've dropped their last two. They go from 11-1 to 11-2. Wilmington goes to 8-5 overall and 4-2 in the OAC. And they just put Bolden Wallace down to 4-2 also in the OAC.
And another important fact, Brittany Jefferson scores her 1,000th point as a Quaker in her career. And so congratulations to her and, of course, to the Quakers for this great win.
All right, folks, that's going to do it for us from here. And maybe tune in tonight on CampusNation.com.
For boys' high school basketball.
McLean Tigers and the Fairfield Lions.
For Charlie Hargrave, this is Rick Phillips. Good night, everybody. Tune in a little later for boys' high school basketball. Go Quakers.